Respected Rashtrapati Ji, respected Congress President, respected Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, and all the distinguished members of the podium, on behalf of the chairman of the committee that has been established to celebrate the centenary of Srimati Indira Gandhi, her close associate Sri R.K. Dhawan, and on behalf of the other members of the committee, I am honored to propose this vote of thanks, first to the Honorable Congress President, who has explained to us the message of Indira Ji, which was fundamentally that she wanted India to show the world the way. These are words that are going to reverberate in our minds over the next 365 days. Also, most importantly, I'm here to express the gratitude of every one of us here for the formidable address we have just heard from the Honorable President of India, Rashtrapati Ji. The voice that we heard from Rashtrapati Bhavan and through Vigyan Bhavan today was that of a young man who was chosen personally by Indira Ji to be one of her closest advisors at a very, very young age. And therefore, what we heard from him was the voice of a lived experience. And that lived experience was reflected in so many of the sentences that he placed before us that I find it difficult to choose which ones to recall. But I think I would like to begin by referring to that letter which Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru wrote to the 13-year-old Indira Gandhi, in which he gave her the injunction, "Be brave." And it was that courage that she displayed all through her life. Sri Pranab Mukherjee has taken us on a walk through the corridors of history. He has spoken to us, given the limitations of his constitutional office, in a manner that has been frank, fair, and fearless. He has spoken both as a statesman and as a constitutional expert, but perhaps above all, as he himself said, as a historian. And from that, he has set the tone for what he hopes and expects will be a national debate on Indira Gandhi right through her centenary year. And at the end of that debate, I'm sure we will come to a national consensus that here was a lady who was totally democratic, always a patriot, and always a leader. Totally dedicated to the nation and her people, as evidenced by the Belchi incident to which President Mukherjee referred, and almost the last lines she left for all of us in papers that were discovered after her death and which the Honorable President has quoted to you. I cannot understand how one can be an Indian and not be proud. That is what has made our country, made our people, and certainly made my generation, for we grew up under the shadow of Indira Gandhi and under her leadership. She was unflinching, as the President said, in her commitment to the poor, and she championed their cause. And therefore, I take the liberty of ending this vote of thanks with words associated with Indira Ji, which will be heard through the corridors of history and into the future generations. Wo kehte hain, Indira hatao. Hum kehte hain, garibi hatao. Thank you. Jai Hind.